In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know to get started with Swift's new testing framework, Swift Testing. We're going to cover the main features of Swift Testing, but also its differences and improvements when compared to XCTest. But before we start, I have a big thank you for the sponsor of this video, Emerge Tools. Emerge Tools is a suite of products designed to help teams build better apps. So whether you want to monitor and improve app size and performance, have an incredible end-to-end snapshot testing solution, or find dead code in your apps, Emerge has you covered. If you want to learn more about Emerge's tooling, you of course have the link to their website in the description. And by the way, Emerge also has a really nice blog where they have some high-quality iOS content for free, so I really recommend you check it out at emergetools.com/blog. And now, let's get started with Swift Testing. Overall, most of the differences between Swift Testing and XCTest share one common trait. Swift Testing leverages all the modern features of Swift, whereas XCTest couldn't because it had been written back in the days of Objective-C. For instance, to declare a test, XCTest would rely on the naming convention that the function name should start with test. On the other hand, Swift Testing doesn't need to rely on such conventions. You are free to name your test functions however you want, because you'll be annotating them with the macro @test in order to indicate that they are indeed a test function. Now let's see how you implement assertions inside a test. In XCTest, the most basic way to write an assertion is to use the function XCTAssert and pass a Boolean expression as an argument. However, when the test fails, all that XCTest can tell you is that the assertion was false when it should have been true. In order to get a more actionable failure message, you have to use more specific assertion functions, such as XCTAssertEqual. These functions require you to break your Boolean expression across several parameters, which in turn allows XCTest to have better semantics at its disposal to report more precisely what caused the test to fail. But with Swift Testing, all assertions are written using the macro expect. And since expect is a macro and not a function, it can access the entire source code of the Boolean expression that you've passed. This allows the macro to understand what's going on and to generate an actionable message should the test fail without asking for any extra effort from the developer. Speaking of macros, Swift Testing offers another very useful macro called require. This macro behaves very similarly to the function XCTUnwrap. It takes an optional as its argument, and it will either return a non-optional if a value was indeed there, or make the test fail if the optional was nil. Now let's talk of what might be my favorite feature of Swift Testing. With Swift Testing, it's possible for a test function to declare one or more arguments. The values for these arguments are then specified through the parameter arguments of the @test macro. And what's really great is that from this data, Swift Testing will automatically generate one test for each possible combination of the arguments and then run them all in parallel. This is a really powerful feature because it allows you to create a really good test coverage of your code with minimal effort. And by the way, if needed, it's also possible to opt out of this behavior. You can use the zip function so that only the combinations of arguments that you've defined will be used to create the tests. And of course, instead of calling zip, you could have also directly passed an array of tuples. And that's it, we've covered what you need to know to get started with Swift Testing and make the most of it. Of course, Swift Testing offers many more advanced features, the ability to run tests in parallel, to group them using tags, to run a test only when a specific condition is met, to assert expected errors, or even to disable a momentarily failing test. If you're curious to learn more about these features, I've put the link to the WWDC sessions and the documentation in the description. Once again, I have a big thank you to Emerge Tools for sponsoring this video. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss my next videos. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.